Welcome back, troglodytes, to Would You Rock or Not? Now, it's not a Gibson today, it's not a Fender, it's probably nothing you've ever even heard of before. Today, we're taking a look at the Sauvage Guitars One Piece Master Collection. This guitar cost $60,000 and is made by a French company. So why is this guitar so absurdly expensive? To put this price tag into perspective, you could buy four vintage 1952 original issue gold tops. You could get two 50s Les Paul Customs with the staple pickups, two brand new vehicles, and this would pay for half of a fairly decent house in my area. So why is this guitar so expensive? I did some research about these guitars, so I'm going to try to help make sense of this price tag, or at least give you guys a better appreciation of this guitar. If you're new to the channel, I'm a fairly open-minded person. I like to learn the history about things to fully understand them. Now please go into this video with an open mind. I know everybody's gonna say $60,000 is way too much. I probably agree, but let's find out why this guitar is special. The very first thing, and the easiest one to learn, is that this guitar is carved and crafted from one huge slab of 100-year-old flamed ash. This huge chunk of wood was dried for 35 years prior to making this guitar, and it had a 7% moisture level. Now, I wish I could say this guitar is 100% completely hand-carved out of this block, however, it's not. They did use a CNC machine to get like the contours right to get the exact shape of the guitar, and then after that they did use some handcrafting techniques. So all in all, it's kind of like a 50-50 type thing. This $60,000 guitar comes in a gig bag, but let's take a look at the layout and design of this guitar. Now, Sauvage's inspiration for these guitars is both classic vintage themes as well as slightly futuristic. They took inspiration from vintage vehicles, cutlery, and all kinds of different aspects to make this guitar exactly what it is today. So the center strip right here is painted aquamarine, which was the same color of the first 356 Porsche that was ever made. In fact, if we look at one of these Porsche cars, you can actually see the hood is basically the same design you have going on here. I'm very surprised that they didn't put a little metal piece over here instead of just relief carving the wood in that shape. The bridge and the surrounds of the pickups are made from Damascus steel. Now, Damascus steel, that's basically what they use to make knives with, really nice fancy knives. Now, I don't think they sharpened them as much as the knives, but that was the reason why Sauvage decided to use this. They were trying to bring in really fancy watches, cars, all the big themes where the big money spenders are. Now, these pickups, they designed them to look like old 50s mics. If we take a look here at a vintage mic, this is kind of the look they were going for. It has a very retro theme to it. However, before I watched the video that kind of explained the conceptual designs of this guitar, I totally thought they looked just like a gas mask. I didn't think they were the most attractive, but now that I can envision the vintage mic, they're a little bit more attractive. Now, this guitar has no pickup selector switch, two volume controls, and a single tone. So in order to get a different pickup sound, you simply just turn the volume off of your pickup and you can blend them to the exact tone that you're looking for. Now, if you're a gigging musician, you might not like that because that's not quite as quick as a three-way switch. However, I can see where in a recording situation where you want to get that exact tone, it would be very beneficial for that. Now, personally, I think this guitar has a very Gretsch-like vibe to it, all the way from the side marker inlays. Since this thing is vintage car inspired, it really does remind me of the Corvette series that Gibson did as well. Now again, this whole body is crafted out of a huge piece of ash, but I really do enjoy the fact that they left the back for the most part natural. It was interesting to see that they did put a volute, but I do like that they have this little accent area right here. It kind of just looks like a giant raindrop. However, I think it kind of breaks up the monotony of just pure ash. The headstock is very simplistic. I like the aquamarine color. And instead of an inlaid logo here, they have a badge bearing the Sauvage name. Now this nut here is actually fairly interesting. It is made from a fossilized mammoth tusk. And the tuners are open back schollers. And these photos really do show off the nice figuring to this wood. And here's another angle that really just shows it off even more. Now, when I first heard this guitar was carved out of a single piece of wood, I thought, well, that is very interesting. I thought they just took this completely from a big block of wood and they just kind of carved it out. However, they did make some cuts. This large piece here is actually glued on, but it did all come from the same block of wood. I thought it was in very good taste, since if anybody does buy this, they're likely a collector. They left the original ash block of wood to use as a guitar stand. So you can simply put your guitar back in where it originally was carved out of. I thought that was a very nice touch. So how does a $60,000 guitar sound? Well, Sauvage also has that covered for you. I'll play a few quick sound bits here, and if you're interested in hearing the full demo, make sure you check out their videos as well. Question left, would you rock a one-piece master or not? Leave your answer down in the comment section below, and regardless of how you feel about this instrument, please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe because I do daily uploads of guitar-related content. Thank you for watching, Troglodytes, and we will see you tomorrow on the next one. Take care.